In this video, we're analyzing the motion of a falling rod. So this rod is hinged at one end so that it can't slip, and we release it from rest at an angle of 60 degrees above the horizontal. We're given the specs on the rod. It has a mass of 200 kilograms, a length of 6 meters. And what we're trying to figure out is the angular velocity of the rod when it hits the ground. And then the follow-up question is to find the speed at the tip of the rod when it hits the ground. Now, this is an energy conservation problem. And the key to it is to remember how the potential energy of a rigid body relates to the height of the center of mass. As it turns out, the gravitational potential energy is equal to the mass times g times the y coordinate of the center of mass of that object. And because this is a uniform rod, the center of mass occurs at the geometric center. So if we use the ground as the zero of our coordinate system, we need to figure out what is that initial height of the center of mass. And this occurs 3 meters along the rod. And that means the height of the center of mass is given by 3 times the sine of 60 degrees. When we run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, we get 2.60 meters above the ground. And again, we're calling the ground the zero of the y coordinate, which means the initial height of this center of mass, I'll call it y center of mass initial, is equal to 2.60 meters. Now we can start looking at the energy conservation problem. I'll just start all the way from the beginning with E initial equals E final. And in our initial state, there's no motion. It's all just that gravitational potential energy. So I have mg times the initial height of the center of mass. And in the final state, the center of mass of this rod is now laying on the ground. So there is no gravitational potential energy. All the energy is in the rotational kinetic energy of the rod. So that's a 1/2 I omega squared. Now we were given a hint in the problem that the moment of inertia of a rod is 1/3 ml squared. When the rod is rotating about one of its ends. So we have 1/2 × 1/3 × ml² × omega². Note that the mass of the rod is irrelevant. That cancels out here. And we should be able to quickly solve for omega. So I need to multiply both sides by 6 over here to the left-hand side, and I get 6g y center of mass initial, and then divide by l squared. And because omega was squared on the right-hand side, we need to square root this result. So we're ready to plug numbers in. And we're going to use 9.8 for g. The initial y coordinate of the center of mass again was 2.60. So I'll just write 2.6. And divided by the length of the rod squared, and that was 6 meters. And I need to square that. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 2.06 radians per second. Now part B is the easy part. Relating the tangential speed to the rotational speed is as simple as remembering the relationship v equals r omega. We plug in the distance from the axis of rotation, which is 6 meters, the angular velocity that we just found, 2.06 radians per second, into 3 significant digits, we get 12.4 meters per second at the tip of the rod. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.